Okay, hi guys. So today we are going to learn about the second method, which is the Macaulay functions. Okay, so we can know that here, double integrations method is adequate for simpler problems. So if the load supplied on the beam is more complex, it is difficult to generate the equations because it involves too many sections. We need to cut many times if we use double integration methods. So another easier and simple methods, which is Macaulay methods. So we need to note that. So x time x minus a, okay, in the bracket, this is power of n. For the value greater or equal to 0, you will have values. But for value for x minus a equal to 0, less than 0, it will be 0. But actually, less than 0 or equal to 0, both you will get 0, as shown here. Because 0 minus 0, okay, you will get 0. Okay, so note that the Macaulay functions, you can say here, x minus a lesser or equal to 0. So equal to 0. Okay, so if x minus a is greater than 0, then we will use that values. So don't be confused with this. So later we will see it in the examples. Okay, so for example number 1, so you can see this, determine the deflection at x equal to 5 meter, which is somewhere here, okay, from the support of A, and the slope at point A for the given beam shown below. So the question wants you to find the deflection at x equal to 5 meter and also the slope at point A here, which is x equal to 0. Solve the problem by using Macaulay methods. Given the value of E equal to 5 times 10 power of 6 newton per millimeter square, and the I value is 9 times 10 power of 6 millimeter square. Millimeter power 4, sorry. Okay, so from first step, we look at this beam. We need to know the boundary condition, which this example is simply supported. So we know that at the support, the y is, the deflection y is 0. So when x equal to 0, y equal to 0. When x equal to 10, which is support B, y also will be 0. Okay, and then step 2, we are going to calculate the reaction force at supports. Okay, so at here, we need to calculate the support reaction because the support reaction also the force that we will consider into the equations. Okay, so to get the equation, the reaction support, we need to use the equation of equilibrium, which is total MA equal to 0. Okay, so 10 from this moment plus 2 from the uniform distributed load times 2 times 2 over 2 times plus 4 plus 5 times 8 the distance minus VB times the distance equal to 0. So you solve this, you will get VB equal to 7 kilonewton. After that, we use the total FY equal to 0. So VA plus VB minus 2 times 2 minus 5 equal to 0. This moment is not considered because this is not force. It is moment. So you will get VA equal to 2 kilonewton. And also from the total FX equal to 0, you will get HB equal to 0. Okay. So after that, step number 3 is you need to cut the beam at last segment of FB. You need to cut it before here. So you can see that this is a support A with 2 kilonewtons from the calculations. And then this 10 kilonewton meter, the moments. And this uniform distributed load 2 kilonewton per meter. However, you need to extend it to the end of these cut sections. Okay. And then when you extend it, so you need to extend top and bottom, okay? Because from top and bottom, when you add like this, extend like this, it will not affect the result because you extended both upward and downward, so it will be 0, okay? So 5 kilonewtons, okay, at the F. So remember, if the uniform distributed load is not end at the cut section, so you need to extend it, and then when you extend it, you need to extend at both upward and also downward directions. Okay, so from this we need to generate the equation for bending moment deflections. So total mx at here is 0, so negative mx because it's counterclockwise, plus 2 times x, the total distance x towards here, minus 10 times x minus 2. Here is the moment, and then moment is located from x minus 2. Okay, at here, we will power it become 0 here. Because anything power of 0 will be getting 1. So times times 1, you will still get this 10 kilonewton meter. This one we need to do like this because later we will integrate it. Okay, remember you must do like this. Else, if you didn't do like this, you will get the incorrect answer when you further the calculations. So another one is you can see that we will have this 2 times x minus 4 times x minus 4 over 2. So this one is from here to here, the uniform distributed load. So this 2 is 2 kilonewton per meter times the distance is x minus 4 times x minus 4 over 2, which is the center of this load, and then minus 5 times 8, 5 times x minus 8. So you will get the value of moment, and also plus the 2 times x minus 6, which is the distance from distance of this is x minus 2, 4, 6. X minus 6 times x minus 6 over 2, which is the location of the loading. Okay, the centroid. So after you move this to the right side, you will get mx equal to 2x minus 10 times x minus 0, 10 times x minus 2 power of 0, minus x minus 4 power of 2, minus 5 times x minus 8, plus x minus 6 power of 2. Okay, so we also know that mx is equal to ei d power of 2y over dx power of 2. So actually, this is same equation with this I just rewrite here. If you want to directly write mx equal to ei d power of 2y over dx at here is also okay. Okay, so after you get this equation number 1, you integrate the equation, you will get ei dy over dx. So 2x power of 2 over 2 plus 10 times x minus 2, 1 power of 1 over 1, minus x minus 4 power of 3 over 3, minus 5 times x minus x power of 2 over 2, plus x minus 6 power of 3 over 6 plus c1. So after you get the equation number 2, you integrate it again, you will get EIY equal to 2x power of 3 over 6 plus 10 times x minus 2 over 2 power of 2 over 2 minus x minus 4 power of 4 over 12 minus 5 times x minus 8 power of 3 over 6 plus x minus 6 power of 4 over 12 plus C1x and C2. So after you obtain these equations, then now step number 4 is we need to solve the equation by using the boundary condition at the first step you listed to obtain the value of C1 and C2. So we know that at x equal to 0, y equal to 0. Then you input this into equation 3, which is the equation 3 I rewrite here. EIY equal to 2x power of 3 over 6 plus 10 times x minus 2 power of 2 over 2. Minus x minus 4 power 4 over 12 minus 5 times x minus 8 power of 3 over 6 plus x minus 6 power 4 over 12 plus c1x plus c2. So you input the value of x equal to 0 into it, so you get 2 times 0 power of 3 over 6 plus 10 times 0 minus 2 power of 2 over 2 plus minus x equal to 0, 0 minus 4 power 4 over 12 minus 5 times 0 minus 8 power of 3 over 6 and plus 0 minus 6 power of 4 over 12 plus C1 times 0 and C2. So we know that from this x minus 1, if it is lesser or equal to 0, x minus 1 will be 0. So from this is 0, so it will be 0. 0 minus 2 is less than 0, so it will be 0. So 0 minus 4 will be 0 because this is minus 4, less than 0. 0 minus 8 will be negative and minus 8, so it will be 0. 0 minus 6 will be 0. So you just cancel out it, you get 0. And then C1 minus times x is also, times 0 also 0. So you will get that 0 equal to C2. So now here you already get C2. Also, you know another boundary condition is x equal to 10, y equal to 0. You substitute this in the equation of y again, which is 2 times 10 power of 3 over 6 plus 10 times 10 minus 2 over 2, power of 2 over 2 minus 10 times minus 4 power 4 over 12 minus 5 times 10 minus 8 power 3 over 6 plus 10 minus 6 power 4 over 12 plus 10 C1 and plus 0 equal to 0. Okay, this C2 value is obtained from here. Okay, you input into it. So after you solve all of this, you will get C1 equal to negative 54. So for this, we know that just now from the equations here, x minus a, if it is less or equal to 0, so it will be 0. So you can see that we double check here, 10 is greater than 0, so you will have value. 10 minus 8 is 8. 10 minus 2 is 8, so it's greater than 0, you will have value. 10 minus 4 is 6, so it will have values. 10 minus 8 is 2, so it's greater than 0, it will also have values. 10 minus 6 is 4, so it will also greater than 0, so it is also having values. So you will want, so from here you can get value of C1 and C2. So after you obtain the value of C1 and C2, you rewrite the equation of EI dy dx and EI y. So you input the value of C1 and also C2. Okay, this is plus 0 here. Then you can get this equation. So after you get this equation, basically you can find the value of slope and also deflections at any location of the beam. You just have to input the value. So according to the questions, you need to determine the deflection at x equal to 5 from a. So we put the x value equal to 5 into the equation EIY. We into this equation, you can get EIY equal to 5, 2 times 5 power of 3 over 6 plus 10 times 5 minus 2 over power of 2 over 2 minus 5 times 5 minus 4 power 4 over 12 plus 5 minus 6 power 4 over 12 minus 5 times 5 minus 8 power of 3 over 6 minus 54 times 5. So this and this value we need to cancel out, become 0, because 5 minus 6 is less than 0, which is negative 1, and 5 minus 8 is negative 3, which is also lesser than 0. So we will cancel this out, and then you solve this 1, 2, 3, 4 values, okay? Then you will get EIY equal to negative 183.41 kilonewton meter 3. So after you move the EI through the values here, because in this equation, you're given E value equal to 5 times 10 power of 6 N per mm square, and also I equal to 9 times 10 power of 6 millimeter power 4. So after you solve this, and then you need to do some exchange of the unit, okay? Then you can get Y is equal to negative 4.08 millimeter. Okay, this negative value, this negative sign indicate that the direction of the deflection is downward. Okay, so step number 6. Okay, it's step number, it's the same step. Okay, slope at point A. So in the equation, they also ask you to obtain the value of slope at point A, which is x equal to 0. So theta equal to what value? So we know that EI theta is also equal to EI dy dx. So the equation is this, okay, 2x power of 2 over 2 plus 10 times x minus 2 minus x minus 4 power of 3 over 3 plus x minus 6 power of 3 over 3 minus 5 times x minus 8 power of 2 over 2 minus 54. So you input the value of 0 into the equation, which is 2 times 0 power of 2 over 2 plus 10 times 0 minus 2 minus 0 minus 4 power of 3 over 3 plus 0 minus 6 power of 3 over 3 minus 5 times 0 minus 8 power of 2 over 2 minus 54. So we need to cancel all this out, because all these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 values are all less than 0. Okay, so 0, negative 2, negative 4, negative 6, negative 8. So we cancel all of this out. We will directly get negative 54. So EI theta equal to negative 54. And then you move the EI to here. And then you solve this by using the value given, EI value. Okay. And then you will get negative 0.0012 radians. Okay, so hey guys, this is example number 1. Then later I will continue with example number 2 in part 2 videos. Thank you.